There we go. So it looks like we got Turnlove. It's welcome to the TDC TSD Tackle Zone Starter in quarterfinals. It's the first of them. We got second one later tonight and Tuesday and Wednesday, the two last ones. We got Turnlove's Amazons, which is got Mighty Blow Wrestle and Banner. I will have preferred a fourth. We've got Super Jace. Orc, which has gone heavy on the blitzers. Two guard Fobs, two guard blitzers. Mighty Blow Frenzy. I preferred blocking up the two last Fobs, I must admit. Got Mr. Throw with nothing and a 9-1. Kick all the way to the end zone. Mighty Blow does a thing. So I think the one overtime is a bit problematic for zones. The three guys I still don't really dig it. Yeah, it's normal over time. So it's normal 6-8 turns of overtime into kicks. So the Amazon roster is a bit fragile. You probably need to win in. It's only 2-1 reserve. Oh, we got plus 2 fame though, but only 2 rerolls. Bloody might need a cup of coffee after watching that. Yeah, I can see that. It's just, its problem is it's a bit of hassle. I will need to validate, and people are not allowed to validate the game, and I will need to change the result of games. I'm using the normal playoff knockout. It's easier for Rebel, plan where we had that system because it is one-off games and the result was wrong, but it can just change the standing. It's not great from using the in-game systems. And actually, Rebel Clan has removed overtime whatsoever, and we can now play draws in next season, which my Amazon's looking very much forward to. I'm so tired and ending in overtime with Chorps and Kemri and stuff like that, so I have to be beaten up for 8 turns more. So I got the ball deep. If I was turn low, I'll probably see how many I could get down in this area. Because that dude cannot get back to the rest of his group. The orcs needs to get down here. So I'll go from the left side here and try to do something. So he did exactly that, tried to put pressure around in this side. Give him some targets to hit, but it means the orcs. I don't like that. There's no reason to run so deep. Our rocks cannot... Oh, I don't like that. I've been running rocks... The problem running this deep is rocks is not going to be part of anything the next time. That's best interest in keeping in so much out of it. Setting up a non-block block. Hey, Bunjo. How are you doing on this fine Saturday? And that's a tasty chain push as well to get further down. It's a bit weird game. I don't really like the orcs not taking anybody back to defend the ball carrier. I don't like the Amazons moving Roxy back so she cannot attack the ball carrier. Sounds lovely. That's been good. I was out with a nice walk with the girlfriend. And we had some sunshine this morning. It was lovely. Oh man, now time to... She's playing Fallout 76. And I can do this. So he's definitely... He's trying to reconnect the ball carrier over here with the rest of the team, it looks like. So interesting now, the zones can either try to get some people again in behind the orbs or actually could also think about just falling back and waiting. Problem with falling in here, putting people up here and those girls. Like, movement 6 is not a lot if you want to bring your team together again later. I think personally I would be tempted to just do some blocking, see if we can get some of those down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Going from it's a good question. It's Thank you. It's just the Spotify, it's just a Spotify playlist called Northern Spirits. I quite like it as background music. I do use it for work as well. So it's the Amazon has gone a little bit of both worlds again. He's dropped a bit. He's been blitzing, doing stuff up here, dropping a bit back, sending some people down to try to stop the orcs from reforming. Hopefully Roxy's coming a bit up now. I would still like Roxy to get all the way up here, so she can actually do stuff. I think you're spending so much money on her. Just having him standing so deep she cannot actually do anything is not worth it. And if the orcs start chasing her, then they might risk losing the ball, which is fine. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, Mars. I don't know. Because you need to be up where she's a threat, and if you use resources to go after her, that frees up players on the team to do other stuff. Frenzy. Yeah, he could, has the image file. But it's not really, like, he could screen her off easily with those players. It's not really that hard. If he's really afraid, but I kind of, again, if he needs to use, it's not one dicing her, that's a 5+. And there's no doubt his reasoning is because he's afraid of her getting hit. That must be the reasoning, I cannot, but yeah, that's the only thing that makes sense. Of course he's afraid of that, but it's just not really. Come on. Gets the 6. Because it's a Roxy build, there's no. So now he's a player down on top of it, and it's a guard piece that is harder. I do also think that guard piece should have dodged out of there personally, instead of just taking hits. Because that was too many dice, he should roll a power on that. to set on kettle. Coffee's over. What did we miss? Not much. Amazon's moving a bit around. Roxy's still hiding. And to be fair, there's two Amazons out. So not even, it's seven Amazons actually defending. So I guess it's the tackle and the frenzy blitz are coming back to hit now. Another alignment. I hadn't hated actually just doing the one last block. The result does mean it's a 2 plus. On 5 plus, it's an upside. But I guess now he's dodging out to Blitz and get Snake, and now. Well, the Lion Woman is getting trampled. And it's a bit annoying not making the 3 plus, but he has made quite a lot of other 3 pluses. Hey, Mother Buckman. Welcome to a bit of Tacklezone Star Division playoff. We got some Amazons versus the Mocs. Still midway first half. Amazons are 3 players down. Technical 4 because Roxana is hiding. Again, I'm done eating biscuits, so I can put my webcam on again as well. Yeah, I might get I might ask Jimmy for the actual pictures, and I can have fun with that as well. Yeah, exactly. I've just PM'd him and asked if he can send it. Oh, Mr. Fro, you're so fucking slow. That's not great. Kind of need to do a go for it, that's not optimal. I don't think he actually needed to go this deep this fast either. And that's why we don't. That was kind of not necessary. BTK. The only reason the Orcs is going early is because if the Orcs want to go early, I think by now when you're this much down, players, they got the guards and can. Guard up. I don't think it shouldn't be necessary for the Orcs to score before 28. The only problem could have been that what, like a go for it like that failing. And again, I don't actually think he needed to go this deep this fast. Let me. Let me add a PTK source. PTK. Now we've got Peter Kay commentating. The camera's up, it's out of move. Sorry, I was doing important work. The camera should auto move as soon as you select a new player. It's a bit annoying, I cannot do what I normally do when I'm playing. If you open the chat, then the window stays exactly there. I do kind of hate it moving all over the place. I guess he's going to blitz the Black Orc now. Yeah, I got it on a window. I've definitely got it in the window. So it's not that weird, it's just because normally when I play, I need to tap out of the window. Oh shit. Oh, it's coming there. It's just lagging. I need to tap out of the window instead of just dragging it out. Alt. I'll not try that. Nope. Maybe. Yeah, oh yeah. Good squared actually. I think I just. Right. That seems about right, it just freezing. But yeah. Copy link. Nah, it should be fine. Like, again. To be fair, that. You cannot take tackle for just that. That frenzy is a bit annoying. He should still be fine, but I wonder if the Amazon has done this a bit earlier. I'm not sure if they get enough out of this late, because he's still just blocking everybody away. Besides those, but there's Black Orc more to come down here. The only question is, I think you move this line up first. Or you could block follow up and then move the line up. I don't actually hate that, so you get guard in with those two. So yeah. Put him there, and that's a bit questionable. Put there and then block again. to the sideline. A bit risky when you move that. You are going to block that one. Yeah, but I don't particularly. Yeah, you could do it. Push it up and then move around instead. And then a little bit. You kind of just want the Amazons to use forces that's not directed in around the ball. If I'm the Amazons here, Owen gets a nice power, so now he can even push down. The problem is following up. I think I want to stay still because it's guard. So he puts him down and the orc lineman can still move around and do stuff. I might even move him up here in the middle. Because what he right now have is actually... I'll do the two against. He could open up the front. Ooh. I don't like that. Now he even more needs to make sure that this is not getting opened. Because if you're blocking two dice against with wrestler block, it's 70% to work. And if it does double pushes, you can figure out what you do. Yeah, but now he's just running out of time instead. Oh, I will be so tempted to do this uphill block. Both down is fine, then the guard is away. The problem is actually double pushes and then you cannot do anything. If you want the really sexy one, it's this way, so you can push there. And then you can one dice without guard. You might actually take the two dice here on the ogre. Okay, if you really... If you want to do something, you take the two up here. Yeah. Then you take the ogre, push the ogre back, leaves two dice on him. I better like that, actually. I like that a lot. Ooh. I really actually like the other solution. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, I'm not crazy about that. I actually better like the two dice against than the non-block with the ogre with the guard. Because then the guard was in, then one of those two could... If he started doing this block first, then this guard hadn't had to move. If he'd done that with guard. But he still got... Oh, and then snakes. It worked. Really, I like to start with the risky move. But guard in, minus two dice, it's a 70%. Because of guard, he will then have been able to two dice him to this side. It's Roxana. It's 8-3-5-7. Juggernaut, leap, frenzy, jump up. She's amazing good synergy. And if you'd gone that way, then Garter could popped in and he could actually... Then it could have been a Garter up here. I think he could get two dice with Roxana. Potentially. But yes, he's so good. But it had been riskier starting with the two dice. Thank you. I'll not stun her. I don't think it's necessary. It was. I don't think I'll stun it just because I don't think it'll make enough difference. You also needed, if the ball was popping free, you needed somebody to try to get out and get it. Where's the PTK go? Sorry, I was popping away, I needed my coffee. Ooh la la, that's not a guard cage. That's bad. Hey Hancock. You keep me. That's the only guard on the back. Ooh. And that's Amazon to pick it up. I'm going for that one, guys, if he's not stopping that. There's no rerolls anyway. I'm freaking coming in with Roxana. I know she's not dead. If you get killed, she's out for the one turn. But that's it. Yeah, that's bad. When you have one, two, three, when you have four guard pieces, you shouldn't be in a position where Roxana can get one dice. Unfortunately for him, Roxy needs a 5 plus because he doesn't. Can he get a guard around, actually? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, he spotted it. He's coming for the rescue. Now it's not a juicy turn anymore. Now it's probably just run Roxana in here and make sure she's there for the one turn attempt. Let's take her, hide her. Blitz and block some people. I still don't like that was necessary, but I hope he did rescue it. Hide, Roxy! Why does he run this? Hey, Flicky Flag! Why is he running to this side? He could have hided Roxy up here. I know it's away from Mighty Blow, but still, fuck's sake, it'd have been easier. Now, if something else had. Oh, he needs to run, yeah, guard over there. Mighty blow hit it, mighty blow. Both down it is. How are you doing, Flicky Flack? Come here to see some mate. Exciting resurrection. Oh, I forgot something. Not really. Which is fine if you can just make, if you can make a one turner with her. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ooh. 1, 2, 3, 4. He needs, to be fair, if you, because Amazon's is movement 6, as long as you if your opponent does anything else than a tight loss, you cannot one turn with Amazon without Roxana. Laid up after got injured by a laundry basket. I bet that's a long story. So So if you, so Orc, start with three dice on the mighty blow with mighty blow. Come, Orc, move over. Three dice on mighty blow. And then frenzy, and then you move over there, or something. And then you're hopefully moving a guard away with a frenzy. Oh, flicky flag, have you seen I got different so we can do. Got PTK in the house. It's fine, I just wanted more blood. Okay, that's fine, I guess. It gives more blocks. The Bunny of Doom. PTK! I really still don't understand. My first priority has actually been 3 dice in the mighty blow, just for the sake of it. Yeah, me too. I started with that and then... Probably not started. I've been moving that guard blitzer away. That's just... And some both downs in some of those could have been so bad. But he can still 3 dice it if he moves now. 3 dice, come on. Oh, now it's hard. Now it's no 3 dice. I think you didn't need to use all 4 players on doing that. Yeah, agreed. Now you're just wasting time because that's not 3 dice. Mr. Pro runs it in! 1-0 for the Orcs. But to be fair, my Bagman, because he doesn't have tackle, if it's me playing the Orcs, I've been hitting line woman. I've been hitting his line women with frenzy every fucking turn. I think it's better option than the blitzer with mighty blow. It's 3 dice with a mighty blower, it's just getting the 4 dice and the non-block players with the frenzy. So it's, I've been hitting left and right with him. That's not a good defense. I hate this defense. I so much hate this defense. Yep. Oh, the problem with this defense has one freaking problem. Bit shame I don't have this on 1920, 1080. See if this works today. Ah, it's a bit annoying. What about if I make my pen 8? Make it yellow. The problem with this whole setup is. This line is literally just giving you a Norman Kelly staircase to touchdown land, because that setup is literally just making you able to chain push down that line. I know the guard there makes it a little bit weird. Why he's not setting up? So that guard makes it a bit weird because then the blitz from here is a one dice. But it's just a one dice. Oh, for fuck's sake. So you should, there should be nobody there. And then you one dice from here up to here. And because there's a guard, you cannot make it better. But that's not going to work. Because. Alternative, you block the okra, but that's not really. What is. What are you doing? Yeah, they have enough. I'm no clue either. I'm getting a little bit in. I'm getting to my one to rip my hair out state. Because this is not working. Oh, 10 love. I have no clue that player what she's doing. Because if she's away, then you split from here into there, and then you use the staircase. Then Roxy is actually standing. Roxy is standing in this square, and then you just push Roxy down the flank. I'm interesting to see what Tenlo's plans are here. Okay, so he's going one dicing. So okay. But that's not. So then you push Roxy over there. But that's. Now you're not. So you took a one dice there, but okay, that could be a fire pass. But you cannot move Roxy the right way on the first block. If this is what you want to do, then Roxy should kind of been standing there. There's no reroll anyway, so. That's really a long-winded way. But if Roxy has been in that spot and somebody else there, then Roxy have been pushed one on the first block. Yeah, but I don't like this way to do it anyway. But now he's at least get to foul the black oak. I'm taking the one dice, and it had to be. It's a 5 plus with no rerolls. It's an average erection, Apple. The orc was always going to Apple the first badly hurt or the first KO he's run into. Orcs doesn't care, it's resurrection. And he doesn't have reserves. The Amazons has a spare player though, Mazen. I don't hate it, actually. It's a good. And it took out the apple, which means now. Yeah, I don't hate it. It took, and especially taking out the apple, which means now if he actually hurts. If you get a KO now in the drive, the orcs cannot save a KO in the drive. But don't hate it. It's plus 5, it's pretty good. I'll take it. It was better than I think I better liked it than his one turn. Because the main thing was, of course, one turning the troll. Hitting the one dice on the troll meant that could be a knockdown. It was a non-block ogre, though. It was a black orc, just a pointless black orc. Yeah. I'm for no black orc, not a black orc. Yeah. And the Amazons is expect each like if he scores too early. Oh, that's actually a problem. You might actually need to score early because overtime too. I don't like overtime. If I was the orcs here, I would just try to make Amazon roll as many dice as possible so they don't have any reroll for potential overtime. Oh, I'm just drawing painless. Let me delete that. I must have. I'm not even sure I rerolled that with two rerolls. Where's the ball? No, I'm not rerolled that. Two rerolls in an overtime game. I'm freaking not kidding. Now I think he needs to go for the win. So scoring and sacking. It's an overtime format. That's mind-boggling. He chose not to take leader. He's not taking the thrower, so he decided. You can do this build with a leader thrower, but he hasn't done that. So you only have two rerolls and Roxy. Yeah, me too, Malzum. I'll take 4 guard. I don't care. I'll take 4 guard. To be fair, I actually think 4 guards is better in almost always. Now he's attempting a. I think he's trying to tame the ogre. The orcs to come down in the middle so he can run around them. But I think again, if I was Super J, I'm literally just. Yeah, exactly. I'm just making him use rerolls. sorry, peeps. Sorry, I've just spotted something in the garden I need to take care of. It's Tacklestone Star Division. It's my Resurrection League. This is the quarterfinal, one of them. I've got another quarterfinal tonight, which is Underworld versus Kimry. So it's a bit different. That's why everybody only have one skills, is because of the Resurrection format. So it's 1100 plus X amount of money, depending on which tier your race is. So I think even with the apple gone, I think if I'm in Hawking I've been seeking more contact. The zones have been, it's because the Roxy build makes them quite fragile. They used the reroll a bit earlier, but I don't particularly like. And it's another double skull is used. This time you might actually need to use it. And that's the problem by using the first Devil's Skull reroll, is this time you cannot use it. Because you cannot use your last reroll. I do think the Orc needs to, I think he needs to keep one of those blitzers a bit deep and central. Because right now this is primed land for a Roxy potato. I'm not sure I'm digging this right now. There's some options. It's a lot of tree blessing, but there's some definitely options. Well, a guard can get out, then you can blitz that guard. And then you're just handing off to Roxy and try to run over here. Then you can even guard out, and you can even blitz with Wrestle, and then you can try to pass it down to Wrestle. Yeah, the problem was he used a reroll on his first block, which was another double skull as well. It's pretty unlucky, but I don't think he needed to use the first reroll. He caught the ball on a high cake. Yep, Roxy Potato. Oh, if you go and burst down like that, you might as well. Yeah, you might as well. The only question, if you blitz with Roxy, I do kind of like this dodging blitzing, but it might actually be better dodging the line woman out and then blitzing that line woman with Roxy and just run down. Dots not used, because this is a bit. Problem is, you kind of want to go there. Or else too far. And Roxy Snake. I think personally, I kind of like going for the blitz instead with Roxy and get him down as well. But to be fair, Ten Love has been pretty shit. He rolled. He messed up a couple of really some ugly dodges and the double skull thing, having the skulls as well. Where's Mr. Fro? Oh, wait a second, it was Mr. Fro she was tossing past. The Orcs winning. Nope, I'm still. Yeah, the only problem dodging out is, of course, that it was a 3 plus. But I kind of. The reason I wanted to dodge out and blitz was as well that mean the throw up will be down on the floor if it worked. So if something happened later, it would be harder for the Orcs to recover. But he's been rolling pretty shit. I'm not sure what we're using 2 minutes for here. But hey ho. I guess because Roxy didn't get break armor, it's still a lot of options next turn. Oh. I'm not sure I'm going to like this turn. And a go for it? What the hell is going on here? I guess the only good thing is it's hard to get guard in, but it's not. So you stand this guard up, and you stand this line woman up. But that's also... Roxy can clear that. Not for one dime. Oh, I can... Copy into there. We can get one dice without blinking. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. So two dodges and then a guard. Move over, dodge in on a 3+, then it's one dice. Could also dodge, then do Roxana. Block. You can actually do Roxana one dice. If you get her up, then it's 1-9. Not sure what's best, that's a lot of options. Not sure. Okay. Guess that's less thinking, just doing. Then Roxy needs to. I'll leap, personally. And get third, and then dodge away. I'm not sure I prefer that plan, because that was one dice into two dice against. But what he. I still don't. But the next one, and then did she snake again? And she snaked again without breaking herself. Yeah. But what the problem was again? I don't particularly. But he could have dodged two times to make it one dice. And also tagging some other players. And it's even like this. So either Roxy's just pure working or she's not. There's no middle ground. The good thing for not really. Problem in blocking 1 in 9 is you don't have a free reroll. So you do stop to think a bit more about that. But no, I don't really care about. No, she's much better. No, she's definitely better. Kif is really good as well. He's also 80k more expensive. Oh, 70k. He's 320 or 330? 320. But he's also. You cannot compare. If Roxy had. He's definitely better because Roxy is also 250, so he's quite a lot cheaper. If Roxy had strings 4. And was costing the same as Griff. Gets the pickup, that makes it a bit boring. But now because the guard is all over the place, and now Roxy can shine. Now he just need a guard somewhere, so Roxy can get 2 dice at the second block. Potentially 2 places. He can block that guy away, then we can move guard in here. Then you just need something here. Hello guard. You can take the 1 dice there, get guard in. Then it's just Roxy, 2 dice, 2 dice, 1 dice, 2 dice. Block. Good girl. Move. Guard to some square. I like personally to do it in that square, but it looks like he. I guess he's thinking Roxy from another square. That's fair enough. Then you're blitzing from all there. That's. Put Roxy up there and then up there. That's fine, then you don't have to go down there, then you can just dodge in. 1 die, gets it on the 1 die, otherwise it'd been the 2 dice. God, that's a pretty shit. You haven't used. Actually, she's not good at using dodges either. There's no way you're not trying to take it up, you cannot be standing there. Pickup failed. She really don't like 3-plussing, does she? Cannot really reroll that, it's a loner. You got 1 reroll. I will say for the prize, because I would say Roxy is pretty high for the prize, because her skills actually work together. Griff is a bit the same. There's a lot of star players that has a really terrible synergy between the skills. But Roxy gives works together. And as a thing for like Amazon, she makes a huge difference because you can do everything Amazons normally cannot do. Where actually, like humans do have speed already. And catchers and blitzers being a bit faster. Yeah, Chaney, Wilhelm Chaney. Only problem with Chaney is the Springs Fall wrestle is the wrestle piece is a bit weird. In a lot of situations, but he's really good and he's good on tabletop because people often forget him actually being catch. So if you could, if everything fucks up, it's a, he's a good Springs Fall potato. See you. Nice throw standing there. Eldred at times can be really good as well. Again, in, especially in low skill matchups like this. Oh la la. Is that somebody been ranking Starbears? Oop, what's that? That's a double skull on Roxy. Yeah, Huckflim. Huckflim's skill spike is actually not bad for what you get. Hemlock is pretty good. Yeah, and that's how much you pay, how much they actually cost. But the other it doesn't really take account, Masum, if the skills, it might be expensive skills, but it doesn't work together skills. One, two, three, four, five, six. Why are you not doing? I've done that as well. It's a thing. I don't know. Roxy, but she's still alive. She can still do it, boys and girls. She can still do it. Yeah, that's again because like all her skills actually fits together, and with her stats as well makes her pretty good. Where does someone just have some weird skill combination? But we've got Mr. Fro now. Yeah, that's a good shout as well. Gets the POW. It's probably the ball game. All you needed. Yeah, they're probably up there. It's brilliant foul. There's no reason not to. And there's no reason to move the Okra now, because he's fine there. Yeah, that's pretty horrible. Four plus two plus three plus two plus one dies
over here.
Wrestle already down the field. Yeah, Skidder and Underworld. To be fair, of the new staff as Krieg is pretty good value as well. The Glad is pretty good value in general. Both the two Glads. Bogalander. It's pretty good value for money. A lot of the new stars are pretty. It's better value for money. But I think that's by design. I might have taken. I think I've done the. Now it's. I think there's two things here. I think I've done the 4 plus. At least tried dodging him out and see if he could get in. Just stop as soon as you reroll. But first of all, you need to get a scoring thread, otherwise, this is pointless. Sacking the ball without being able to score. Because if you have a scoring thread, you can go down on the both down and leave the ball is free, and then orcs can fuck off. Now the orcs has won. Because there's nobody that's scoring from Amazons. So I think that's a bit of a mistake. First off, should definitely be getting a scoring thread. Yeah, that's. And in this turn, it should have been the scoring thread. One of those two should have been dotting down to be a scoring thread. It could have used the reroll. There's no reason to save the reroll. Oh dear. A prop bet, yeah, maybe. Definitely not particularly necessary. Yeah. I think he might go for the score just because. Yeah, he is. Come on, Mr. Fro! I guess he kept the reroll too for the touchdown. It resurrects and it doesn't matter. Blocking, fouling, who cares? It's not going to do anything in the playoff. But congratulations to Zibadier and the Hawks moving on to the semifinal. Who is he on? He is. He is playing the winner between Count Looper. So he's playing the winner between Delhopia and Nimelec. So that's a humans versus Elf Union. And tonight later we have CTA Blackburn's Underworld versus Strider's Kimry. Tuesday we got Justitium's Chaos Dwarfs versus Tempo Gigant's Wood Elves. And then finishing off on Wednesday with Veli's Humans versus Nimi Elekin. So, Elf Union. But again, congratulations. To Zibadier. Four armor breaks. Not particularly well. That's not many blocks at all. How many blocks did the zones end up throwing? 19 block versus 70. Oh my god. So yeah, the next